Hey guys, welcome back once again to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I will show you around the bridge. The bridge is the control center of the ship, or you can say the cockpit of the ship. There are several equipments here and I will show you around one by one what all these equipments are and what all they are used for. So without any further ado, let's get on with it. First of all, I will start with this. There is a beautiful statue of Bappa and Jesus Christ. They look after us and they always look after the safety of the ship. Nothing bad will happen to us. So the most important equipments in the bridge are these. This one and this one. This is called a radar and this is called a neck disc. So basically this one right here, this shows where we are in the world right now, and this one shows what lies ahead of us. So this is a radar. Radar stands for radio detection and ranging. What it does is it has an antenna up top, and the transmitter of the antenna, it sends out electromagnetic waves to the outside in all the directions. Those electromagnetic waves, they travel all the way up to a distance, quite some distance, and if there is any obstruction or anything which is lying ahead, it gets hit by them and then it gets reflected back to the ship. And the receiver unit of the antenna then detects those waves and it calculates how much distance, how much time it took to come back, and it calculates the distance by that, and then it paints a target on the screen. So right now it's open sea, so there is no target, but once there is a target, it will be detected and then it will show a target painted on the screen. So that's how the radar works, and that's how we come to know that there is any target which is lying ahead or anywhere in the open sea, and that's how we detect and we avoid that, and that's how safe navigation works. Now this is an ECDIS. ECDIS stands for Electronic Chart Display and Information System. It's nothing but electronic charts. In earlier days we had paper charts, like maps. To be speaking in very plain words, we have maps of the world, and now we have electronic charts like these. So after 2015, it is mandatory to carry these electronic charts. So basically it's a computer and this is the chart which is loaded in that. And this is our ship right here. So right now we are coasting of the southwest of Mexico. So this is Mexico, and it's our ship. We are 40 miles off from the Mexican coast. So that's how ECDIS works, and there are various features here given here with the position and what course we are following. All these things are there. So these are various things which can be seen on the chart. So these are lights for navigation. They help in the navigation when you're coasting. So there are two of these. So one radar over there and one ECDIS over there, and this is the backup ECDIS and another radar. This is a different band. There are two bands of radar. One is called an X band, one is called an S band, and this is another ECDIS. So if anything happens or if this is malfunctioning or not working properly, this one we can use. So there is always a backup for everything on the ship. So two ECDIS and two radar. Okay, so this is the different alarms panel. I will start with here. This is the main engine control. Right now the control is with bridge. When we are done with maneuvering, the control goes to the ECR. And if either of them are not working or functioning properly, it has to be operated from local. And also there are options given for the wings. See, that is a console over there outside, and one more console over there in the bridge wing. You can operate from there as well. So this is basically the main engine console. The revolutions per minute and the scavenge pressure also displayed over here. and this is the engine load. Anyway, so let's not get into details. This is called a telegraph. This is also the different RPMs and the different speeds given. This is basically like a gear of a ship, a car. So say for example, first gear, second gear, third gear, fifth gear, and so on. So similarly, stops, engines are stopped, dead slow ahead. So this is basically the gear system of the ship. And also going astern, the reverse gear, there are also different reverse gears also. So that was the engine part. This is the bow thruster system, which is fitted in the forward. So bow thruster, we just use this knob to go starboard and port during maneuvering only. And this is the Banwas reset. So see, the Banwas is basically just an alert system which alerts the duty officer every 12 minutes. So what happens is, if the duty officer is not awake or if he's incapacitated or if something happens to him, the Banwas will alert him first, and then it will alert the captain of the ship, and then it will alert the other members of the ship. There is three stages of the Banwas. So first it will alert the bridge, whoever is on the bridge, that okay, you are not, get awake and see what is happening. And then if it doesn't if the duty officer or the person on the bridge doesn't acknowledge that, then it will go straight to the captain, and the captain will come to know that yeah, there is something is wrong, why the duty officer is not acknowledging the alarm. So he will immediately come up, he will see if everything is okay, and even if the captain also doesn't come, then it will alert the whole ship, and then somebody must come and see. This is given because the bridge needs to be always manned, and somebody needs to be alert on the bridge. That is why this system is given. This right here is the alarm reset button. So once the alarm comes after 12 minutes, you have to reset to let the alarm system know that everything is okay, everything is fine. This is a whistle button for the ship's horn, the forward horn and the aft horn. We can select this forward and the aft horn. See, from here, this is the aft horn on the top, and that is the forward horn in the forward part of the ship. This is the whistle press button. One more is there in the forward also, that's over here. That is the whistle button. So there are different places, different given. Pappa Murthy. This is very unique in many of the ships. Maneuvering table for the main engines. And this is the alarms buttons, reset buttons. If any alarm comes in these panels, this is the steering gear panel actually. If any alarm, there are different type of alarms. See, failure alarms and the power fail alarm, these are, so anything alarm comes, this is the reset button for them. This one resets the light, and this one resets the sound. For testing purpose, this is given. So say for example, I want to test the buzzer. See, it is working now. Okay, so, and this is the heater for the bridge. One heater is provided over here. So if it is cold inside, you can switch on this heater and it will work. The whole bridge will be heated up. It will be very cozy. I do that often now when there is, it's chilly outside. This is the window wiper. For the wipers on the screen, I will show you how to do that. First I will power on. Let's get the dimmer on. So this is the power on, and now I will press the master. See, all of them are working. Stop. This is useful when it is raining. You can control them individually by these as well. So switch it off. This is the AIS, or automated identification of ships. Every ship which is passing by within 100 miles of your ship you will get to see them here. So say for example, this is the closest one, that is 58 miles from here. So this is the details of the ship I will get. The name of the ship is Valence, the call sign, the IMO number, and all that things, details I will get. So it will show all up to 200 targets within 100 miles. So, and this is a distress button for that GMDSS console, I will show later. This is a VHF, or very high frequency telephone. So this is its also, I just press it here, over here, and then I talk. I press it here and then I talk to the other ships or port authorities who are listening. This frequency is the distress frequency, There are other frequencies as well. You can change it by number of the whichever channel you want. You can change it. So generally at ship we keep the distress frequency all the time. This is a UMS alarm panel system, and UMS is UMS stands for unmanned machinery spaces. So unlike the bridge, which needs to be manned all the time at sea, the engine room does not need to be manned all the time. So that is why this UMS alarm system is given. It is given on the bridge so that if any alarm comes in the engine room for any machinery or anything, the bridge will come to know. And engineers will also come to know. They have their alarms in each of their cabins, so they will also come to know and they can immediately. And this is the Banwas system. So right now it's only left 30 seconds. After 30 seconds it will give an alarm. I'll show you how it, what alarm it will give. And then I'll have to reset it. I can reset it from here or I can reset from the button which I showed earlier as well. And these are different alarms as well. There is a hospital alarm. If there's an alarm system, I'll show in the hospital video. When you press that, this hospital alarm will come. And the reefer chamber alarms are also here. Navigation alarms are also here. Banwas failure alarm. Many alarms are here. Okay, so now it is blinking. This is the first stage. It will blink and visual alarm. The next stage, it will give an audio alarm. Just now, right now it will give. Just wait and watch. Now it is given audio alarm. Now if I don't acknowledge it within a minute, it will alert the captain. So I now reset it. It again went 12 minutes. Again after 12 minutes, it will give an alarm. And this is the pumps. This is the emergency fire pump in the forward. Bilge pumps. The remote controls are there from there. You can just press it and they will start working. And these are the emergency stop switches for different fans and different pumps which are there. So this button will switch off all these pumps. This button will switch off all these machineries and vents. That's there. This is a fire alarm. If there is a fire, you can just break it. You can just press it. This is very fragile. You press it and it will give an alarm throughout the ship. And there is a manual for this as well. So you just open it and press it. It will give the general emergency alarm. So that's very simple. All these things. This is a telephone, the bridge telephone. The numbers are given over here. Another telephone is over here. Those are the same things, interconnected. You can just pick up any one of them. This is an emergency telephone. So what happens is there is a this is the emergency sound telephone alarm. Not this is not available everywhere. This is only available at these places. So what you need to do is you just check. You have to call captain's day room. You select two from here. You select the knob and you select two, pick up this phone and you just dial, you just rotate it. So this is powered by sound. Okay, these are electrically powered and these are sound powered. So if the ship occurs any blackout or if the electricity fails, you can use this phone. You just select where you want to call and you rotate it and this will call that particular station. This is the steering system of the ship. Basically, in a car you have the wheel, the same thing is this thing. So right now it is on autopilot mode, and the autopilot mode settings are here. This is a set course I have maintained. As you can see, this is our set course. This is 300 in the compass direction. This is our plan course 300. So exactly I am doing the same thing. I have set this as 300 and the autopilot, it is maintaining 300. If I have to switch from the autopilot to hand, I will switch to this. I'll just press this knob and I'll put on hand, then I will do steering by this. So if I give, this is a starboard 5 degrees, it will show over there starboard 5 degrees. So these are GPS receivers. We have two GPS receiver, number 1 and number 2. This is DGPS, which is an advanced form of GPS, differential GPS, which is basically the same thing. So much similar to the GPS which are there available in our cell phones today. And this is the light panel. This is the lights which are running always as long as the vessel is moving. And these lights are showing whatever lights are running on top on the Mikey Island, which you saw in my previous video. And this is a Christmas tree, which you saw earlier in my previous video. These are the light controls for them. This is another VHF, very high frequency, much similar to the other one over there. This right here is the GMDSS console. GMDSS stands for Global Maritime Distress and Safety System. In plain words, this is the radio equipment of the ship, the main heavyweight, heavy duty radio equipment. This is the medium and high frequency receiver and transmitter. This is an Inmarsat C. So there are different types of radio equipment, and this is just the Inmarsat C, and that's the MFHF or medium high frequency. And these two are the printers for them. So what any message or anything comes here, it will automatically print over there. So basically this is used for emergency purpose. You know, if we are in distress or something, we can send distress messages, safety messages, and also we receive weather messages or any warning messages which are applicable to our route. We receive all that from here. This is the workstation of the bridge. We use it for a different kind of paperwork. Printer is another one. This one is exclusive to the captain, and we use those. And this is another planning station for all the charts and all. These softwares are installed in here. This is called a chart table. Although nowadays these charts are gone basically, so the chart table sizes also have reduced. And this is, you know, just for paperwork and everything. And not really very relevant nowadays. And this is the master clock. This one shows GMT or UTC, Greenwich Mean Time, and this one shows the local time or the ship's mean time, which we are maintaining. This is a GPS repeater for the GPS which you saw earlier there, and this is a speed log. It tracks the bottom or the water, and it shows how much speed we are doing. That is an eco sounder. It is currently switched off. It sends out the signals to the bottom depth of the sea, and it calculates how much depth is there below the ship, very much similar to a sonar. So right now the depth is more than 1,000 meters or something, so it is not required really. When the depths are very less than 100 meters or something, we use that. This is a barometric pressure indicator. It indicates how much pressure, atmospheric pressure, is there right now. And basically this is what it looks like from inside the bridge, and this is the main area, that's the outside, and these are the console and equipments. This thing is called a gyro repeater. So we have two compasses on board. One is the magnetic compass, the standard one, and another is a little modern one, a gyro compass. All ships right now use a digital gyro compass, and this is only its repeater. So this thing is a Pelorus, so if we just need to focus on something, and then we can take the bearing, and it will show the bearing over here in digital, how much is the bearing, 3201. It is a total of 360 degrees, and it will show exactly how much. So if any ship is there, we take the bearing for this, and it will show how much is there, similar to what the radar shows. This is a manual one, and radar will show the same thing. This is an LEDs lamp. It is used for attracting attention of other vessels. It is used for that. These are binoculars. That's the pantry over there. We use it for making coffee and all. There's a microwave. These are also emergency VHF equipments. They are running on batteries. These are the spare batteries kept for these walkie-talkies. In kind of emergencies and abandoned ship, we carry them. We can use them for communicating. This is a watertight door indication panel. In the accommodation, the watertight doors which you see, which you saw in my earlier video, which we have to open by a knob, those these rubber packing wall doors, those doors are only, they have sensors there, and this panel indicates that only. So whichever door is open, it shows red like this. This one is open and the rest are closed, so those are green. This is the panel for that. This is a fire alarm panel. If any, there are sensors throughout the ship. If any sensor detects smoke or fire, it will show here and here. This panel also does the same thing. This is a smoke detector system for the cargo holds, and these are the pilot door racks. So there is the extreme side of the ship where the pilot door is there, where the pilot comes through that door from the ports. That door has an extra safety for it, and that's the sensor for that. So these are the bridge windows where you see the outside from these windows, and these are the wipers for them. This is what it looks like, the outside from inside the bridge. And these are the top consoles. These are basically repeaters. This is a speed log which shows the speed of the ship. That's the RPM of the main engine. It is the wind. It shows where the wind is coming from, direction and the speed. The relative speed, of course, relative to the ship. This is a ship's clock. This is a clinometer. From here we see whether the ship is listed to any side. So if the ship has to be upright, you know, technically all the time. So if it is listed by how many degrees, this thing will show, this one. This is the rate of turn, how much degrees the ship is turning to which side. This is the radar angle in a digital form. This one is the gyro repeater, the heading. And this is the eco sounder, which is currently switched off because of too much of depth. And this is a safety locker for on the bridge. There are two EVDs inside and two life jacket and immersion suits. And there are 12 rockets, parachute rockets. Inside, these are the rocket parachutes. This is what a parachute looks like. I will show you about these in a detail in my lifeboat video. And this is a line throwing appliance. So what happens is, if you use this, you hold it like this, you remove this and you hold it, and you can just use this to throw a line. So this is used in case of emergencies or where there is too much strong wind, where you cannot pass lines by hand, you use them. And this is a first aid kit box, that's an emergency IOS. And life jackets and immersion suits are here. And these are EVDs. And these are some files, paperwork files on the bridge. Some planning plans. There are some files over there as well. This is the bridge toilet. That's a course recorder. It records the heading of the ship all the time. This is a fire plan, very similar to the one in the accommodation which you saw earlier. And these are the rest of the computers. And this is the bridge wing. This is the starboard side bridge wing. There are only two things here. So that was it, guys. That was the bridge tour, all the equipments I've shown you on the bridge. I hope you now know that what all is there on the bridge, what all we use on the bridge to navigate the ship. This is basically the cockpit of the ship, and now you have a clearer idea about what all things are here, what all equipments are here, what we do basically. So I hope you like this video. If you did, don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Until then, stay safe and stay blessed.